Afternoon baseball here on the show. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Minnesota Twins and the Seattle Mariners. At the plate, Luis Arraez. He will lead this one off today. The 1-1 is a swinging strike on the sinker. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Swing and a liner. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard. Standing in now, Jorge Polanco. Fastball too low, and that's ball four. Up next for Minnesota, Nelson Cruz. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. And that's upstairs, running the count to 3-1. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. And another foul ball. Payoff pitch one more time. Hit on the ground out to short. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And he's retired one away. So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. He went hitless last night in a game where his guys could push across only one score. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Arraez, the runner at third. Polanco is over at second with one down in the inning. To two balls and two strikes now. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Josh Donaldson digging in now, previously with Taiwan Walker. He's just 2 for 12. He also has one home run. Hard hit ball to second. Gordon is there. On to first, and the Twins are turned away here as the side is retired. Here's D. Gordon now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A 1-1. This is line to left. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. So that puts the leadoff man aboard to get the inning underway. To the plate now, Malik Smith. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. To second for one. Return throw is in time. And what do you know? They do get the double play. Mitch Haniger the next to bat. No one aboard for him. And two gone here in the first. And he goes with the slider here as that misses in tight. It's ball four. Dan Vogelbach is next. Took an 0 for 4 in the victory last night. A bouncer up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And the throw will come in quickly from center. So despite the hit and run, they won't get the extra base here. Into the box, Carlos Gonzalez. And Gonzalez lays off as he goes to 2-1 now. And a swing and a miss as that looked like self-defense there. It's 2-2.
In a big spot like this, you have to be looking for something you can handle. That pitch bunched him up completely, so I think he's trying to do a little bit too much right now.
Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. The next twin up, Mitch Garver. In 8 at-bats in the series, he's collected 3 hits. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
Vogelbach makes the catch, and there's one away. Ready now, Eddie Rosario. He's got 3 hits in 6 tries for the series. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side. Stepping in now, Max Kepler. A 2-ball, 1-strike count to the Twins' first baseman.
As a veteran out on the mound, that's a pitch that you expect to get a call on. Got to believe he keeps pounding that spot until he builds a rapport with the umpire.
Drilled to the right side. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. And that runner will go no further than second as there are 2 aboard now.
Batting nine, the center fielder, number 25.
In now, Byron Buxton. In there, now the throw. And he can't find the handle, actually, as he must have been caught off guard. It's a double steal. The 1-2.
He really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
Swing and a miss. A big strikeout, and he's 1 out away from working out of a jam.
The batter number 2.
Stepping into the box, Luis Arraez. He singled his last time up.
Yeah, and just another simple single to the outfield would be a big one.
And the third baseman makes the play. That ends the inning. Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager, and he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Two and two.
Hey, you'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor, and he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
And he fouls this one off. Now another 2-2.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Smoke the other way, high and deep to left. Back goes Rosario. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Digging in now for the Mariners, Tom Murphy. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Three and one. And he misses here for ball 4. Already 2 walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. And that'll bring in J.P. Crawford. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and 1 away. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are 2 gone. In now the Mariners DH, Dylan Moore. He drove in 3 of his team's 4 runs in last night's game. The 1-1. Waves and misses for strike number 2. Bottom of the second here with no score. And he takes very close to the inside corner here. 2-2 though.
Well, he's been laboring a bit through these first 2 innings of work. That's 37 pitches, and ideally he'd be closer to 27 instead.
And he takes ball 4, so a good job out of the 9-hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. And here's the speedster D. Gordon. 2's all over the place. 2 on, 2 out, and of course here in inning number 2. That's in there. Base hit. Now a long throw home. The tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. At the plate, Jorge Polanco. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Now batting. Right field.
And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. The 1-1 home. It's the outside corner for the second strike. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Smith. One away. Now it'll be the Minnesota DH, Miguel Sano. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
And you can live with punching out with the bases empty, but in his last at bat with two runners in scoring position, you cannot go down not putting the ball in play. Too much on the line, too many ribby opportunities out there to swing and miss in that spot.
Chopped to third, tough to get two. One there, relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Malik Smith the next to hit. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. A little bit outside. 2-1. Swing and a line drive, but foul. Mariners center fielder now with a full count, three balls and two strikes.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Hit back up the middle, and this is going to get on through into center, a leadoff hit.
Now batter, the right fielder.
So now to the plate, Mitch Haniger, fouled away. Now a move over to first. A dive, but he's back. Nobody out, runner on first. And it's fouled away. Just missed with the 2-2 count, and it runs full now.
Defense has got to be on their toes right here. 3-2 count, runner on first, has got some serious wheels. You know he's probably being put in motion.
Got him.
Up next for Seattle, the first baseman, Daniel Vogelback.
The 3-1 pitch is taken for strike two.
I think it's a real possibility that they put that run on first in motion. That would help them stay out of that double play that would end the inning, but that's also kind of risky at the same time.
Therefore, it is Donaldson, and there are two away now. Here's Cargo, Carlos Gonzalez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 2-1 is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. And a dive, but he's back. Here's the 2-2. Runner goes for second, and a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Settling in now, Josh Donaldson. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four. Standing in, Mitch Garver comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Now the payoff pitch home. Chopper to first, might only get one. No runs, three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Smith will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Ready for another chance? Eddie Rosario. He reached on a single in his first try. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. But it bends just foul into the second deck. Ground ball sent back up the middle. There's one. On to first, and it's another double play. They're second in the first four innings as that one will retire the side. Now at the plate, Kyle Seager. He'll lead things off against Kenta Maeda. A 1-1. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. And no one will track it down. The 1-2.
Nope. I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get the chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still got the entire arsenal open to him. So we'll see what pitch he comes with next.
This is hit the other way out toward left field. Rosario is there. One away. Next for Seattle, Tom Murphy. He drew a walk his first time up. Full count now. Now the 3-2 pitch. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So two are gone here in the M's half of the fourth. And that brings up the shortstop, J.P. Crawford. There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Ground ball right side. A flip to the pitcher covering as that will retire the side. Set for the start of the inning, Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. One for one after a single his first time up. Fouled off. Drilled down the line, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. Here's Byron Buxton now. He's 0-for-1 thus far. No runs, three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. 1-2 now.
Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on a proverbial rocking horse all night. Changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now. Number 9 batter comes through that time as it'll now be up to the top of the order with one away.
The batter number 2, second baseman.
To the plate now, Luis Arraez. A pitch out, the throw, and just great defensive baseball there as they will nail him at second on the pitch out. On, he hammers it to deep right field. Ranging back is Henniger. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Homer Bailey will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign.
Number 15, Homer.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Into the box now, Dylan Moore. Now the 1-1 pitch. Fly ball out toward right field. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the first out.
The batter.
So it's back to the top of the order now. And up next is Speedy D. Gordon. Here's the pitch. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. And that is down, as that could be two bases. And that will hop over the wall now, as he'll be awarded second base here. It's a ground rule double. Into the box now, Malik Smith. And a splitter swung on and missed that time, and that'll be out number two.
The batter, the right fielder.
Ready with the 1-1. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Right fielder looking up at the track, the wall. And they take the lead. It's gone.
Awesome swing right there. You never know when that huge moment's going to come in the game. I know there's a little bit left in this one, but certainly they got to feel good about themselves.
Hey, anytime you can put some points on the board, we're not sure if this is going to be the difference in the game or not, but certainly when you get a big swing like that, I make the fellas in the dugout feel a lot happier about the way this one's going to turn out at the end.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Into the box now, Jorge Polanco. He'll lead it off here against Taiwan Walker.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Now standing in, Nelson Cruz. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2.
Not too many guys taking the mound today with this good a split. Look at the downward action on that thing. It's falling off the table.
Seager is there. And that's the second out of the inning. Here's Miguel Sano.
The designated hitter. Miguel.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. So digging in now, Carlos Gonzalez. He'll match up with Homer Bailey now to lead off the inning. Had him fooled there as this is lifted in the air out to left center and shallow. Rosario comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number one. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kyle Seager. He flew out in his last at bat. And he lays off again, ball three. Tom Murphy waits on deck. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Buxton will range to his left and put it away. Two down. And that'll bring in Tom Murphy. Two out, nobody on. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. All even now, 2-2. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Seventh inning ready to roll. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. It was a walk in his last trip.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
So striding forward now, Mitch Garver. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. The 3-1. Swung on and missed. A full count now.
He is in complete command out on the mound today. He's got all four corners locked in, and now he's raising eye levels to boot.
Lifted down the line and left. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now a ball lifted high in the air towards shallow right center field. Henniger is there and he'll bring this one in. Now in the box, Eddie Rosario. One for two in the ball game thus far. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Rolled slowly down the first baseline. The 2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Smith. And that ends the inning.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Tyler Duffy gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 21, Tyler.
Bottom of the inning now. Into the box, J.P. Crawford. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
But that finds the first baseman's glove, and that's a tough first out.
Now batting, the designated hitter.
Digging in, Dylan Moore. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And he fouls this one off. One out, nobody on. Out of play. Fouled away. Fouled off.
Hey, have an AB right here. I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
3-2, a full count to the Mariners' designated hitter. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, but this is back into the seats, a foul ball. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole and getting on base as we go back to the top of the order. So the lineup flips over and digging in. D. Gordon has got three hits, including a double to this point. Runners on the move for second. Popped high in the air. Polanco is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble. And there are two away. Digging in, Malik Smith. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north is...
And hold on there. That's not going to get him in there with the stolen base. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Bounce towards the second baseman, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Digging in once again, Max Kepler. He'll start us off in the eighth.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Here's another 1-2.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
Just hung in there on that one. Pulled toward right center field. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first out. Carl Edwards Jr. will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. So that'll bring in Byron Buxton, who was a strikeout victim his first trip and then collected a base hit his last time around. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. Oh, and he can't come up with it. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
The batter number two, second baseman,
Luis. Into the box, Luis Arraez. This pitch is popped up. Murphy waits on it, and that's the second out of the inning. So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that will bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. Throw over to the bag, and a dive, but he's back in. A runner on first with two away. And again a throw, and he'll dive back in. Now the 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number two.
Hey, it's tough when your team is being held scoreless on the scoreboard. He was trying to put him.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Tyler Clipper is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 36, Tyler.
Trying to pick things up where we left off, Mitch Haniger comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. The 2-1 home is a changeup that gets him off balance for a strike. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Daniel Vogelbach. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Vogelbach behind, a ball and two strikes. Bases are empty, one man out. Count still at 1-2. And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2. Doesn't chase after the splitter, and he works it back to a full count. Now the 3-2 pitch. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Now batting, Carlos Gonzalez. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. A swing and a miss there, 2-2.
Boy, he looks strong out there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side. And
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Matt McGill comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Set to start the ninth in this one. Here's Nelson Cruz now. Not providing much out of the three hole in this one. Hitless in three at bats so far.
Looking for base runners here as they're down two playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
And it's fouled away. And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth. Now the number four Minnesota hitter, Miguel Sano. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Two and two. A runner at first with no outs here. Full count, three balls and two strikes to the Twins DH. Josh Donaldson, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle, and he fouls this one off. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. Aire Adrianza will be summoned now to be the pinch runner. So it's first and second now. Nobody out. And that brings up the former American League MVP, Josh Donaldson. The 1-2 is a slider taken for a ball.
What pitch recognition right there. 90% of the guys are going fishing after that nasty slider.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. So a big moment here, and standing in, Mitch Garver. And he does so representing the possible go-ahead run. 1-2 to the Twins catcher. First and second now, one man out. This is foul right side. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going.
He was looking for a swing and a miss breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Ready for another shot now, Eddie Rosario. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Oh, and look at this. High in the air and deep. And when this ball comes down, they'll have taken the lead. Home run. In now, Max Kepler. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Taylor Rogers enters the game to finish this one off here in the bottom of the ninth.
Number 55, Taylor.
Stepping up now, Kyle Seager. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 2-1. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Adrianza is there, and that's not the start to the bottom of the ninth this crowd was hoping for. One away. At the plate, Tom Murphy. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
And a base hit into left field, so they've got themselves a one-out baseline. Standing in now, J.P. Crawford. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch. Full count now, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. It's on the ground to second. Did he get his double play? To second for one. Back to first. A double play. And with that, the ball game is over.
Man, they battled right to the end, getting the tying run aboard in the ninth. But that's where the threat ended as they turned a double play to finish this one once and for all.
A one-run game this afternoon, 3-2, the final finish. The Minnesota Twins came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Tyler Clippard claims the win out of the pen, his first. Taylor Rogers hammers down the save, his second. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
For this afternoon's ball game, for the victorious win, 3 runs, 6 hits, no error.